Alright, so what's up everybody? If you're not familiar with this game by now, then you've been living under a rock. It is called Homesick. It's an indie horror game, and seeing as Halloween's coming, I figured I would do a playthrough of this because I just discovered it myself, and I kind of dig it. It's pretty cool. I'm not going to go through like the instructions and all that. There's enough of that shit going around YouTube. Basically, I'm going to show you guys how to, like, rape the shit out of this fucking game, because I had figured it out, and I've beaten it about, like, 10 times now, and I try to get faster and faster every time I beat it, but, yeah, I'm going to showcase some stuff for you. So, first off, the examine, item, icon is pretty much useless this entire game. It just sets the mood, I suppose. Always make sure you check behind this picture, because I've had a couple times where the safe was actually behind this picture when I, and yeah, okay, it's not there, but it seldomly is there. But if it is there, then it gets kind of confusing because there's two safes on the upper floor and there's one down here, and I was running around the one time and I was trying to look for the third safe. I didn't know where the hell it was, and it was like right there. So always make sure you check that. The cabinet is that's usually a pretty good spot for stuff. Now I'm playing this game a little bit recklessly right now. Normally I moonwalk all over the place and try to avoid the killer, but I know how to escape his clutches every time I run into him, so I'm gonna showcase that a little bit. Like, every time I run into him, I can get away from him. Like, people usually panic because of the initial jump scare of him appearing, and then they freak out and don't know what to do and get stuck in a corner. So yeah, this is actually gonna be the, balcony ending, or the balcony escape, because I got the rope ladder. So the first two items you're going to find are always the crowbar and the scrap piece of paper with the digits on it, and then on the off chance you're going to get that rope ladder, and that's going to be one of the alternate exits. The main exit is the front door. There's the balcony, and then there's the basement door that requires a large key. So the final key item is always going to be different. It's always random, but the first 5 key items are always the same. So you're going to get the crowbar, the piece of paper, which leads to either the balcony door key or the dungeon key, and then either one of those lead to each other. So yeah, you'll see what I'm talking about. But right now we're looking for the crowbar because we have the final component, which we have the item to escape the house. Now we just have to find all the keys in order for me to get to the balcony so I can escape with the rope ladder. But pretty much, rule of thumb, don't be flailing around your flashlight everywhere, because he'll appear. And he seems to be a bit time-based as well. Like, if you don't encounter him for a while, and then you start opening a lot of, like, cabinets and stuff, like, after about, like, 15 cabinets, he'll just appear if you haven't, if you haven't spawned him with the flashlight yet. So, if you notice that, like, you're opening a lot of containers, and you don't want to be surprised by him popping out of container, then it's best to just flail your flashlight around, spawn him, get rid of him, and then start, like, looking for stuff again. So, yeah, we haven't encountered him yet, but I'm expecting to encounter him at least twice on this playthrough. There was one playthrough I did where I didn't encounter him whatsoever, which was amazing. Like, I wish I would have recorded it, but, yeah, I'm still new to all this stuff, but pretty much, yeah, you're just going to search, like, every single possible location. Once you memorize where everything is, it's, like, it's pretty tedious. The first, like, 5 minutes of the game is really, really tedious, because there's so many places to search, but then after that it becomes, you narrow it down, and the places, become more static. So, yeah, let's see. Is Buddy going to spawn? Nope. Not yet. So there's 4 possible spots. Oh, there we go, we got the crowbar. So now we don't even need to bother searching. Don't even bother searching anything. Once you find the crowbar and the scrap piece of paper, don't even bother looking anywhere else in the house, because now the next destination is the basement, and the next item is always going to be in the room that is beyond the passcode that you have. It's always going to be in that room, that right when you enter the basement, which I kind of find is a little bit shit, because, like, why would they put that door all, like, right underneath where the entrance to the basement is? Like, I don't know, it's kind of cheap. Like, as you can see, like, I'm using a key item to open the cellar door here, and then I'm going to use the next one right away, like, right next. There's no reason to even move in the basement right now, so it's, like, kind of I don't know, it's kind of lame, but I haven't run into him, so chances are in one of these three cabinets, or the two cabinets, or the box, he's going to spawn. So get ready for a jump scare, people, because it's probably happening. Nope. Yep, there he is. So, now what you want to do is just... Seeing I don't want to run the length of the entire basement because it's really obnoxious, it's long, so I'm just going to go back upstairs. And then I'm going to shut my flashlight off and hang out near the kitchen door. Do not hang out near the side of the room because he'll spawn up there and kill you. Because he always spawns in the room with you. So make sure that your cursor's on the door so she's facing away from an open area. Because if there's one thing I've noticed, if you're facing a wall and you turn the flashlight on, he doesn't spawn. So now that the music stopped, the thud's gone, you turn the flashlight on. Now just to be on the safe side, you can moonwalk the whole way across the room if you want to. But I don't think he's going to be there, so yeah. Now what we have to do is go back, and you always have to search... Like, you should always research the areas that he pops out of, because chances are he was standing in front of the item, and that's going to really throw you off, because the item is in this room. It's not going to be anywhere else. So the next key item is going to be either the balcony key or the dungeon key, and it's going to be in the box, for sure. So what do we get? We're definitely going to get the dungeon key because we have the rope ladder this time. So yeah, everything's going to be pretty fluid. So there's not too much up and down with this walkthrough that I'm doing, which is a good thing. It'll be short and sweet. It'll probably be one of the fastest runs you're ever going to see in this game. Okay, so now this opens this door right here, and this is the room with the dead bodies in it of your buddy and his family. So what I like to do is I like to moonwalk up against the wall here, because there's two bodies right here that you have to search, and there's one over here, and it just stops you from having to turn around in the room and possibly spawn that douchebag. So basically, search this body here. Nope, it's going to be in the final body, which means, yeah, I'll probably just turn around and walk out of here, because whatever, we're almost done. Okay, so now this code is to the safe upstairs, which is in the bedroom, I believe? I think? I don't know, we didn't even look, so I'm going to have to go find that safe now, but that's like, it's only in one of two possible spots. It'd be nice if it was in the room right outside the balcony that I need to go to, but probably won't be. We'll check the bedroom. Oh, I made a mistake. Whoops. I overshot that mark. Wasn't even paying attention. Okay, I always hate getting up there. I always hate trying to click on that. Alright. So we got one encounter so far. I'm assuming there's going to be at least one more. Just for shits, I might just spawn him at the end, just for some tension. It'll be fun. I always usually do that just to, I don't know, I'm so used to this game now. It's, I don't know, it scares a lot of people, but it scared me initially when I first started playing it, but once you get used to it and you know what you're doing, it's actually, I wish it was scarier. It's kind of a joke once you figure all the mechanics and everything to it. It's not that hard. So, now, alright, so there's a 50% chance it's going to be here. And there he is. So we can run past him when he first, you got about 3 seconds. And then what I do is I start running to the right here, because that's our next destination. Turn the light off, and walk into the next room. And now just to be on the safe side, I'm going to run all the way to the right side. And I'll just chill. This is the door that we actually have to go into. The safe is going to be right above my head after he disappears. Hopefully he's not in the room when I turn around, but I'll moonwalk. Oh, whoops, I have to click off, because it's stupid. Otherwise the game doesn't progress. Okay. Okay, so he's gone. Alright, now just to be on the safe side, I don't want to turn around again, because it's just going to be a nuisance. So, yep. Just hold this here. Or search it, whatever. Alright, and that's the key to the balcony, which is right in front of us, and we're home free. That's it. Game is pretty much over. So now, this one probably confuses a lot of people, because, you know, they run to the end of the balcony, and they're like, okay, where the fuck do I use the rope ladder? And I thought it was, like, on the end, like, the very end, but it's actually, like, just before that, like, right in the background here. So if he's chasing you down at this point, you can really get flustered, but see where that arrow's pointing? That's where you have to escape. If you tried, I tried to do it over here, and nothing. So, yeah, just for fun, I think I'm gonna spawn him. But hopefully he's not in front of me. There he is. And, yeah, here he comes. Oh, my God. All right, yeah, but you can still... Oh, my God, fuck. Fuck, 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 fuck. Get out. Yeah. So that's it. That's Homesick. That's how you beat Homesick. That's how you kick the shit out of Homesick. And hope that helped all you, you know, sissy Nancys, you know, conquer your fear of this game, because it's really not that bad. It's just him popping out of nowhere. That's what really gets you. Like, but if you just keep your cool and shit and run away from him like you're supposed to and shut your flashlight off and hide in a fucking corner somewhere, you'll be fine. So basically search every area and just do exactly as I said and you'll win the game. You will beat Homesick. So yeah, I guess thanks for watching. If you know, anyone even does watch this video, probably gonna get like 5 views if I'm lucky, but I was just bored, so I decided to do this, because I've been playing this game like crazy the past week. I just like pop it on and, you know, go with it, like, just to see what, I don't know how fast I can beat it, or if I can beat it without like encountering the killer. I try to like challenge myself doing it, but yeah, it's fun. It's a little fun. It's a fun little indie game. I wish it would evolve into something bigger. Like, it'd be awesome as like a full-fledged game with like more depth, but you know, what can you do? It is what it is. It's cool. So yeah, it's getting early. I need to get home. Oh my God. Homesick.